We have never finished a game and it is time to change that. So in this year's Wowie Jam came along, we knew what we had to make. A game. So what do you think? Did it all go as planned? It did not. We had Friday from 10 until Monday till 8 to make a game where you cooperate with an AI. The great thing about this gem is that we could work together and use previous utility code and assets. So, the Friday of why did we make goggly eyes? We had no idea what kind of AI we want to cooperate with. And since we still work part-time, we still had to work a part of the time. Also, we had to communicate with our sponsor, which ended up making the whole video possible after all. So this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends.
Let me tell you a secret about a hidden gem of a game. Okay, you might have already heard about it. I even have reason to believe that it's one of the most influential mobile games of all time. Raid Shadow Legends. Raid's got a ton of champions. Over 600 now. And all of them come from unique factions, all with their own history in the world of Teleria.
The elves in Raid are pretty awesome. They formed civilization like thousands of years ago, surviving orc rampages and the collapse of the Lizardman Empire. And through all of that, they remained so cute. But this dude, Syroth, got into their heads and created the power-obsessed Dark Elves. And they tried to convert the whole kingdom of Avaria to shadow magic, because they thought it's cool and edgy. And the whole kingdom descended into brutal civil war. But in the end, the Dark Elves got exiled, and Avaria was rebuilt. Now it is the brightest, richest, and most powerful country in the realm of Teleria. My favorite High Elven champion from Raid is Ares. She's super strong and I like her armor. And this month, Raid's got a full schedule of special events and activities, including Forge Pass Season 3, with amazing rewards such as a limited edition artifact set. Raid's also bringing out some new champions and some awesome looking champion skins for the incredible Madame Ceres. Later this month, Raid is giving everybody's favorite champion the upgrade he deserves. Death Knight is becoming a legendary champion. I can't wait to see how the ultimate Death Knight turns out.
This is the best time to get started in Raid. And if you click my link in the description or scan this QR code here on the screen, you get bonuses worth $30.
We're talking a free epic champion Rector Draft, 200k silver, 1 energy refill, 1 XP boost and 1 engine shard. All this treasure will be waiting for you here. After discussing a few concepts, we decided we wanted to make an arena survival kind of game. We got a bit hooked as we tried to make one in just 10 lines of code. But of course there was a lot missing and this was our chance to fill that up. And we were already 10 lines down that path. That of course we could not use because they were terrible. However, we thought it would be cool to have the robot do the bullet telling, while you supply it with XP. It would be a nice robot though that loves you. A good boy that kills people. Killboy 9000. Exactly. 9000! We made a defining decision for the art style. Googly eyes. After we recently dipped our toes in procedural animation, we just wanted to make some use of that, and it looks so lively. You can even try them out in the editor using a tool script, which was super useful and kinda fun. It turns out this is more or less what we got for day one. Why is that, you ask? Because we had a barbecue with friends for the rest of the evening. And it was great. Luckily, between marinating the vegetables, we managed to squeeze in a few more sketches for the art style. And then we gave everything eyes. Our plan was the following. On Saturday we would do all basic gameplay interactions, so that stuff moves, shoots, etc. On Sunday we would do all weapon upgrades. We need like 40, so that the player can level about 20 times and have plenty to choose from. We will come to regret that decision. And on Monday we wanted to do all the rest. Start screen, meta progression, dev screen, actually winning, sound effect, background music. Now that I say it out loud, it sounds like a lot.
Saturday off. Get it playable today. We need this thing to basically be kind of a game at the end of the day, except the content and the polish. And of course we woke up late because Friday was long. The first thing we needed was a player character. Luckily in this genre we could get away with very, very basic movement. We simply get a key input and move there. Great. Enemies also don't need a lot of brain. They can just find the player and move towards him. No need for pathfinding because there will only be a flat plane. No need for multiple targets, etc. We discussed whether Killboy should be vulnerable, but we decided against that for now. Of course, the player should be able to take damage, but we forgot that and will not think about that for a while. For the enemies, we needed a spawn algorithm. We basically choose a site where they spawn and random one of the axes for their position, so they are placed just off screen. This gives a nice illusion of enemies being everywhere on the plane. We added a SAR orbital so we can try out collisions and damage, but we had not made the SAR yet, so we cloned the wheel because it's round. Of course they need to take damage, so we gave them a bit of a flashing animation. Knockback makes them much more responsive, but it comes with problems. When many enemies are on screen, they will just collide with each other and cancel out the knockback instantly. We could do some fancy maths to transfer the knockback, but we found it easier to just give them soft collisions. They pass through each other and we add a slight force that moves them apart, which is very easy and effective.
And then we fell into a rabbit hole. When an enemy died, we wanted the player to bring the XP to Killboy. Sounds like a fun way to support your buddy. But how do we do that? Fitting with the procedural animation, we wanted the player to collect a chain of XP and drag it behind him. And this wasn't that hard. We could just use the same code that keeps the pupil inside the eyeballs when moving. Simply add all cogs to the chain and iterate them from front to back. We also slow the player based on a curve that we can easily adjust and that we never touched again. Giving the XP to Killboy was a bit harder, and it's still bugged here. But with that we were tired and done for the day. Are we in schedule? Of course not! We can't take damage, or die, or win! Our saw is a wheel! This will be hard!
My anxiety has kept me up for over 50 hours.
Sunday of 40 f***ing... upgrades? We woke up early because we knew we had a lot to do. But implementing upgrades like this is something we are confident in. We have a lot of practice with our main game and can use our workflow. We wanted to give the player a really pathetic basic attack that feels whack but is also kinda good. So we added the
stick wiggle.
It has a long cooldown and bad range, but it can kill. And with that you can earn your very first few levels to upgrade Killboy. We wanted to do 8 upgrade trees for him, each of them with at least 4 upgrades and one crossover to another tree. So we started implementing. The saw now looks like a saw and has upgrades that make it larger and faster and more. A beam of friendship that does insane damage and a combo skill that adds a saw to the beam. Grenades that explode with a delay, they can spawn little grenades. And drones that you can upgrade to deliver grenades. Also a giant black hole that can upgrade grenades so they pull in enemies.
When it came down to the passives such as damage up, move speed up, etc., we had to make a decision. We could implement passives as we had planned, be done relatively quickly and try to get back on schedule, or we could fill all other slots with weapons and weapon upgrades because this would be cooler. We looked at the schedule and all the things we had left to do, the meta progression we had forgotten up until now, the difficulty curve, a win condition, playtesting, and we decided these things sound like Monday problems and kept in the flow of making weapons. And while this sounds dumb, we were confident everything else is gonna be quick and a day is a lot of time. And look at the badass upgrades we made. There's a flamethrower that can ignite the cannonballs and generally just toasts. This pistol can now multi-shot and shoot large cannonballs. But it has gotten late and we needed to go to bed without getting the last few upgrades finished. My brain had just melted.
The Monday of all the rest. So it's time to collect the leftovers. We woke up extra early and still have the cannonball upgrades to do, and also some of the other crossovers. We decided to drop the crossovers, but the cannonball ones were important to us. For the meta progression, we had budgeted about 30 minutes, including UI, saving, checking requirements, and their in-game effects. So we took some shortcuts, implemented some very easy to make stats, and just dumped everything into a dictionary. Not pretty, but very, very fast to implement. A consequence of our 40, now 37 or something upgrades is that they all needed descriptions and we wanted flavor texts. So we split up and Dorothea drew the final graphics while I wrote all these texts. An hour later both of these things were done and we felt quite good about ourselves. We still had about 8 hours left on the clock. Nevertheless, we still could not take damage, so we had to count that. And add the possibility of player death. The game was somewhat playable now, so we made our first build online and sent it to a friend, waiting for feedback. Until then we confronted our nemesis, sound effects. And I don't know why, but they always give us trouble. Finding the right ones in the right style, mastering them, making that the cluster grenades do not bust your ears because they all detonate at the same time, it's always a hassle. But we managed to do some juicy stuff when collecting hearts. We also let a computer voice speak encouraging words whenever you give Killboy an upgrade.
Hearts are tasty.
And our feedback is there. Nothing works except a stick attack. But why? We tested the builds locally. Don't panic. It turns out, everything can break when you export it. Based on the name of the upgrade, we dynamically load its code. But the code files are named differently after export. After we fixed that, the game could finally be tested. And of course, tons of other problems emerged. And just like that, we only had 2 hours left and still had to make dinner. We were able to get in a few playtests and fix what is broken and start preparing the upload. That needed a surprising amount of stuff we had not thought about. But we even finished 10 minutes early and went for a walk. Fresh air. After all this time. The days after the jam. Results. So while we show you the final results, what has come of it? People really liked the game. We even made place 7 in and place 2 in topic, which is amazing. This game jam has been really intense and we are so proud of the result. I never coded as much in my life and I'm a software developer. For us, finishing stuff was always hard and now we just put it out there. Since then we made an improved version that even added a 2-player mode. You can play that version for free on itch and the link is in the description. Also, we are working on making Killboy a full game. You can already wishlist it on Steam. This is also the place where new versions will come through now that the jam is over. Turns out, writing a bullet heaven game can be done in 10 lines, but when you want it to be kinda good, it takes 1686.